So I planned to film just that last mask fade transition to show you guys how to do it, but once I got out there and started filming, I decided to make that short little sequence you saw of a market here in Ho Chi Minh City, Vietnam. That mask fade transition is commonly used by Brandon Lee in a lot of his films. So let me show you guys how to create that in the editing room. All right guys, this is gonna be a tricky one to get down. It takes quite a bit of minor adjustments to get everything looking right, but Brandon is an absolute pro doing this, so do not get bummed if yours doesn't turn out like his. Just practice as much as you can. So I have my two clips right here. It is very important to have both clips moving in the same direction as well as making sure they are both stable. The shakier your clips are, the harder it's gonna be to match them up so they look natural. You're gonna mask the shot that is going to be shown latest in the sequence. This is the shot you will end with. I'm not sure why I put good ending here, because it's not. I come out of a bus, which plays no role in the sequence, but for the purpose of this tutorial, it'll have to do. So go into your effects window by pressing Command 5 and find the draw mask effect. Drag this onto that ending shot and begin masking out the area that your previous shot will appear to be in. So for me, it is this grate in the side of a bus. Before you begin masking, make sure to press all of your control points as well as your transform points. This will ensure that all of your changes in your masking points will be saved frame by frame. Let me tell you, it is an absolute bummer to mask something only to find out that nothing was saved when you go back and look at it. The trick for curved objects is to press Command and click and drag on a Mac to bend your line. After you've masked out the shape, you'll need to press Invert Mask so the inside will show the first clip, not the outside, and then click Original so you can accurately adjust your mask in the shot. Your goal here is to line up the mask with your edge line, skip 3 frames, and then adjust. The reason we skip 3 frames is because Final Cut Pro automatically adjusts the mask gradually based on that first point and that 3 frames over point. It is not always perfect though, so you may need to go back and adjust it a little. What I did here was use the scale slider, and I increased or decreased the percentage in order to match the outline. That way I don't change the mask's shape, just the size. However, when I panned the camera right, it did change the dimensions of the outline, or at least it appeared to, so in this case I did need to adjust those side lines. An easy way to do this is hold down Shift, press in those points you want, and you can drag all of them wherever you'd like at the same time. After your mask is lined up well in the shot and doesn't look fidgety, you can move on to the beginning shot that will fade out. What Brandon does in his films is he scales the previous shot using the transform tool to make it flow with that oncoming masked shot. If he didn't do this, it would look like this. It doesn't look horrendous, but it does not have that same effect. The way we do this is by pressing the transform tool on that first shot. We add a keyframe where our ending shot starts to come over top. Our goal here is going to be to bring the scale down for this shot to match us pulling away from the entrance of that oncoming second shot. I hope that made sense. Basically, we want to make the first shot smaller since we are pretending to pull back away from that first shot. This will automatically be saved because you did press the keyframe at the beginning. It'll take a while for you to adjust the scale so it looks proportionally natural. Something Brandon does occasionally that may help you is freeze framing the ending of that first shot so it's static. This will make it easier for you since your shot will not be moving in contradiction with that overlapping second shot. I freeze framed for this clip, but I realized I didn't have to because I wanted to fade it out sooner than that freeze frame. Anyways, once you think you have made the shot and the mask look natural enough, you'll move on to fading it out. Click that first shot and press the inspector window. Then go to the opacity slider, press the keyframe at the point in the shot where you would like to start the fade, and find the point in the shot where you would like it to fade out. I wasn't happy with the gradual fade, meaning where I pressed the beginning point and the end point and let Final Cut Pro fade it out itself, so I adjusted the opacity at different increments in those frames. Just find what you think looks best. After that, you'll copy the top clip and place it below that first clip so your timeline kind of looks like an Oreo, and you'll go into that copied clip and delete the mask effect. And there you have it, folks. If you guys have any questions, shoot me a comment below. I am always down to chat with you guys. If you enjoyed this tutorial, then you would enjoy my other videos on this channel, so consider subscribing. And make sure to press the thumbs up button if this video helped you out. Enjoy your day, guys.